In the previous video, we looked at how to create user accounts for family members that share your PC. In this video, we'll show you how to set up accounts for other people that might also want to use it, like friends or colleagues. Before you can set up an account for someone else, you need to be signed into your PC with an administrator account. The administrator is like the manager account that has full control over the PC, and it's automatically assigned to the first account that was created during the initial Windows setup, so it usually belongs to the computer's owner. All subsequent accounts that you create are standard accounts with only limited control, which helps prevent other users from making unwanted changes to your PC. To check if your account has the administrator role, open the Start menu and select your account icon on the left-hand side, then go to Change Account Settings. This will display your account details, including whether it's an administrator. If it is, then you can set up a new account for someone else by going to Family and Other People on the left, then selecting Add Someone Else to This PC at the bottom. First, enter their Microsoft account email address if they have one. A Microsoft account is just an email address and password you use to access Microsoft services like Outlook.com, Xbox Live, or Skype, etc. So if they already use any of these services, enter the address they use to sign into those, then click Next, followed by Finish to add them to your PC. And that's it! Alternatively, if the person you want to add doesn't have a Microsoft account, click the link toward the bottom to set up a new account for them. Then have them fill out the form. We've run through this process in the previous video on adding family accounts, so check it out for more details. Lastly, if you just need to give basic one-time access for someone, you can create a local account for them instead by clicking the link at the bottom. A local account is an offline account, so it's specific to this PC only, and can't be used to sign into other PCs or any of Microsoft's online services. It also can't be used to download apps from the store, so it's perfect for giving temporary access to guests. Once you've entered the account information, click Next to finish up, at which point you're all set. To modify an account once it's set up, just tap or click the one you want to edit. You can then change the account type from a standard account to an administrator, which is useful if you want someone else to help you manage the PC. You can also remove the account later if it's no longer needed, which will also delete all the user's personal files too, like their documents and pictures. Once you've added the accounts you want, they'll appear on the sign-in screen each time you unlock your PC, so users can choose their account from there, then enter their password. The first time anyone signs in, Windows will take a few moments to set things up for them, and they'll need to be connected to the internet. Once that's done, they're ready to go. To switch to another user, they can open the Start menu and go to their account icon on the left, then select the user they want to switch to. This way, other users can sign in at the same time without anyone having to close their apps or sign out first. When they're done, they can either switch users again if someone else wants to use it, or sign out if they've finished using the PC. They can also just lock the PC if they want to take a break and come back to it later. In the next video, we'll show you how to personalize your account by adding your own picture, setting up different sign-in options, as well as choosing which items you want to sync between your PCs and devices.